Jeanette, I want to talk to Peter Burroughs. Get him on the telephone for me, will you, please?
This hour?
Get him for me. I'll be in the library. No. No. No, Peter. Blaisdell. Matthew Blaisdell. Well, I just come from a party at the Patrick's, and I heard that somebody gave him the money to fish the bit out of that rig of his. Well, it means that he started up his operation. That's what it means. I want to know who it was that gave him that money. Yes. Yes, indeed, I have my suspicions. Yes, I suspect it could be Patrick. Or it could be Harrison or McCready or Wilson or Manning or Colby. You name it. Correction, Peter. You find out.
You're your friends, Blake. Colby, Harrison, and the others. They're old friends. It wasn't one of them.
How do you know that?
Because I know them. I feel it.
Well, let me tell you something about friends, Crystal, my friends. In this business, your only friend is a dead enemy. The minute you hit the ground, these friends would turn on you like a pack of hungry dogs.
Why do you say that?
Well, because if the situation was reversed, I would do the same to them. You're trembling.
It's just it's cold in here. I don't enjoy seeing you upset.
You know something. You're the only person in this whole burnt-out world that I feel comfortable with. I mean, really comfortable.
That's awfully nice to hear.
Sometimes the pressures are so heavy that...
I know.
Now, Fallon, she's never been easy. But I think she's beginning to come around now that she's married to Jeff. Notice any change in her?
Yes.
Stephen.
He'll come around too, Blake. You'll see.
Blake. You know, when Stephen was born, his mother wanted to name him Blake. And I said, well, I said no. I don't know the reason why. I just said, let's name him after your father. Think the boy might have sensed that? Do you think that could have affected him in some way?
I don't think so.
Crystal, our child, when we have one, and I know we're going to have one soon, we'll call him Blake, all right? Our child, the one that you will give me.